Hi everyone, welcome back to Chemcourse Academy. So today we can see some points regarding electronegativity. So electronegativity is first defined by Pauling. So Pauling defined electronegativity of an atom as the tendency of the atom to attract electron to itself when combined in a compound. So what does it mean? So let's say A and B. AB is a bond. Here two electrons are there in a bond. So the electronegativity is defined as the tendency of the atom to attract electrons to itself. So let's say A have high electronegativity. So what happened? A will attract these electrons to itself. A will attract these electrons to itself. Then we can say A is electronegative. So Pauling define electronegativity of an atom as the tendency of the atom to attract electrons to itself when combined in a compound. Now another point is small atoms are more electronegative. Nearly filled shells of electrons have higher electronegativity. So small atoms have high electronegativity. Small atoms have high electronegativity. Now Pauling scale. A2B2 gives 2AB. This is a reaction. A2 plus B2 gives 2AB. Now the wave function can be written as phi AB equal to psi of A plus constant psi B. Phi AB is equal to psi of A plus a constant psi b. So if constant is greater than 1, the molecular orbital is concentrated on B atom. So B acquires partial negative charge if this constant is greater than 1. If the constant is greater than 1, then what happened? The molecular orbital will be on the B atom. So B will get a partial negative charge. So the bond become slightly polar. So A become positive and B become negative. Partially positive and partially negative. So this is a polar bond. Polar bond. Now if the constant is less than 1, A gains partial negative charge. If the constant is less than 1, then what happens? Molecular orbital will be on A atom. So A will acquire a negative charge and B will acquire a positive charge. Then also the bond will be polar bond. Polar bond. Now AB bond stronger, extra bond energy is called delta. Now this AB bond is stronger bond. When it becomes a polar, the bond is stronger bond and an extra bond energy is there, that is called a delta. This is delta. Now this delta is determined by equation delta equal to actual bond energy minus energy for 100% covalent bond. So actual bond energy minus energy for 100% covalent bond. 100% covalent bond means what? This AB bond and AABB. The equation is what? A2 plus B2. A2 means AA and B2 is BB. So these are covalent bonds and this is partially polar bond. Partially polar bond. So actual bond energy minus energy for 100% covalent bond. So energy for 100% covalent bond is root of energy of AA into energy of BB. So energy of AA into energy of BB. The root of energy of AA and energy of BB is called the energy for 100% covalent bond. Then actual bond energy minus energy for 100% covalent bond gives you delta, that is extra bond energy. Now this is very important. Electronegativity difference between two atoms is 0.208 root of delta. Delta is the extra bond energy in kilocalorie per mole. If it is in kilojoule per mole, then 1.017 root of delta. So this point is important. Electronegativity difference between two atoms is 0.208 root of delta and 0.1017 root of delta in kilojoule per mole. Now, electronegativity varies with oxidation state of element. So when oxidation state changes, electronegativity changes. So electronegativity is depending upon the oxidation state of an element. Now another scale is Mulliken scale. So Mulliken scale is also important. Mulliken scale is based on ionization enthalpy and electron affinity. So ionization enthalpy and electron affinity are the parameters for Mulliken scale. And average of ionization enthalpy and electron affinity is the electronegativity of an atom. So average means IE ionization enthalpy plus EA by 2 will give you electronegativity. So this is the symbol for electronegativity, chi. Now another scale is Allred-Rochow scale. Allred-Rochow scale. So it is defined as attractive force between nucleus and an electron at a distance equal to covalent radius. So it is the force. So it is defined as a force which is between nucleus and an electron at a particular distance. So F is equal to E square Z effective. Z effective divided by R square. R is the covalent radius between two nucleus and an electron. So electron affinity is defined by Allred-Rochow scale as 0.74 plus 0.74 plus 0.359 Z effective divided by R square. So this is asked in previous NET exam. That is Allred-Rochow scale electronegativity is depending upon the R square and Z effective. How? It is directly proportional to. Chi is directly proportional to Z and directly proportional to 1 by R. Or inversely proportional to radius and directly proportional to Z. So the square of R square is inversely proportional. Chi is inversely proportional to R square and chi is directly proportional to Z. So it is very important. 0.74 plus 0.359 Z effective divided by R square is electronegativity according to Allred-Rochow scale.
Next is strength of electronegativity. So across period in periodic table, elements become more electronegative. So across a period, that is from left to right in a period, in a periodic table, the elements become electronegative. So more electronegative. Electronegativity increases across a period. So basic properties of elements are inversely related to electronegativity. So basicity is inversely related to electronegativity. And next point is positive charge increases, electronegativity increases. So for example, Mn2 plus and Mn6 plus. So here, which is more electronegative? Higher positive charge, higher cation, that is Mn6 plus. So Mn6 plus will be more electronegative. And next point is electronegativity high than non-metal. When electronegativity is high, then it is non-metal. That is already said here. Left to right electronegativity decreases. So in a periodic table, the right elements are usually non-metals. And here metals. So left to right electronegativity increases, the elements become non-metal. And when for metal, the electronegativity is low. So for electronegativity high, then it is non-metal. For low, it is metal. And another point is electronegativity increases, positive charge increases. So Fe 2 plus is less electronegative than Fe 3 plus.
So scale is 0.74 plus 0.359 is effective by R square. Then Mulliken scale is ionization enthalpy plus electron affinity by 2 will give you the value of electronegativity. So electron affinity and ionization enthalpy is what? Electron affinity is the energy for accepting electron, and electron negativity is for attracting electron. So electron affinity is accepting, and ionization enthalpy is what? Attracting. Sorry, electronegativity is attracting. Both are different. Electron affinity is accepting electron, and electron negativity is attracting electrons. So electron affinity example is Cl. Cl will accept one electron, and electronegativity is attracting electron. Now Pauling scale is the point in Pauling scale is electron negativity difference between two atoms is 0.208 root of delta in kilocalorie per mole and 0.107 root delta in kilojoule per mole. And electronegativity varies with oxidation state of element, that we have seen. Mn2 plus is less electronegative than Mn6 plus. When oxidation state increases, electronegativity increases. And electronegativity is what? The tendency of the atom to attract electron to itself when combined in a compound, and small atoms are more electronegative. So that's much about electronegativity topic.